Hey.
Oh, okay. Hi, what's up?
Garcia found a frostbite victim, admitted to the hospital 3 years ago by the name of Tom Fallon, completely off the grid, just like Sarah, but his mother, Mary, still lives in town.
Great, let's go.
Kate and Morgan already went when we couldn't find you, which is why I've been waiting here for 24 minutes and 18 seconds, so that maybe we can finally talk about what's wrong.
Nothing's wrong. I'm fine.
You're not fine. You're obviously displaying symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder, which absolutely makes sense. We're coming upon a year since your abduction and torture, and anniversary dates have a power all their own, not to mention the fact that seasonal weather changes bring back smells that you probably now can only associate with the initial event. All that I'm saying is that what you're going through is entirely textbook.
In here. Stop it. Stop it. Stop doing that. Stop being you.
I can't help it.
Yes, you can. You can. You think you know what's going on, but you don't.
Well, then explain it to me, JJ, because all I know is my friend is hurting, and when I see her in pain, I want to make it stop.
All right. All right. Give me a word.
A word?
A term. A label. Something that explains what I have, because it is bigger than PTSD, and right now, that word is Tavon. Tavon Ascari.
The man who tortured you.
Oh, he was more than that. He was my partner in Afghanistan. I didn't know he was a
double agent. I know, I read the file you were attempting to extract intel from a woman named Nadia. He set a trap and he killed Nadia and her daughter. Listen, JJ, you cannot blame yourself for that.
The Humvee, was that in the file?
Yeah, you almost caught him. He set an IED to take out your convoy, and I know you were wounded.
I was pregnant. You see, if I had never gotten involved, Nadia and her daughter would still be alive, and Henry would have a little... What is the word for that, Spence?
I don't know.